Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see together how to use Adobe Photoshop Lightroom CC quickly and easily. Leave us comments to improve our future guides. This software is one of the very best ones to manage and edit photos and pictures. Just like Photoshop CC, you can edit and manipulate photos. But the tools and the features in Lightroom are more suitable to adjust photos rather than editing them completely. Let's see how to start. The workspace is composed by different parts. On the extreme left, you have some panels used to select your photos or check any preview. On the center, the main photo preview, where you do apply any tool to edit and adjust pictures. On the extreme right, you have all tools and features to edit your photos. These do depend on the workspace selected above, from library to web. If you don't see those, make sure to click on the vacant space on top. At the very bottom, you have a quick navigator, used to pick the photo you need. Open it by hovering or clicking on the vacant space at the bottom. Close it, clicking on the down arrow. First of all, you need to import your photos. In Library section, go to Import in the bottom left corner. Select the folder that collects your photos on the left, and its files will be shown on the center. Lightroom can import just photos and videos, so just those will be listed. Mind that you can't edit videos unless they are first frame. To import, go to the Import button in the bottom right corner. Just all checked files will be added inside Lightroom. Use Check and Uncheck All to select your files more easily. On top, you can choose how to handle the import operation. Adds files in the Lightroom catalog, while Copy and Move do copy or move the checked files in your Lightroom catalog and in your computer folder set on the right. All photos imported are collected inside the Lightroom catalog, called All Photographs, included in the catalog section on the left. If you need to import other photos, go again to Import. In case you want to remove photos, right-click on one and go to Remove Photo. You can choose to remove it from the Lightroom catalog only or from your computer. The library workspace is used to manage and organize your catalog collections. On the left, you find all your catalogs and computer folders you imported from. On the center, a preview of all photos imported, ordered by number, and, on the right, some quick adjustment tools and any photo metadata. Lightroom has different previews for your photos. Grid view is the basic one, which shows a basic overview of your photos. Through thumbnails on the right, you can set the dimension of the photo thumbnails. Loop view shows just one photo per time. Use your mouse wheel to scroll or select from the quick navigator at the bottom. Hover the picture and use your mouse wheel to zoom, and click and drag to pan. Compare view shows two photos next to each other. Select from the navigator to change comparison. The library section is also useful to apply quick, simple adjustments. For example, while in grid view, you can fast rotate photos using the arrows in the photo corners. On the right, in quick develop, you can adjust the settings for lightness and clarity. Click on the black arrows on the right to show all sub-options. Use the left and the right arrows to decrease or increase each value. Edited photos will show a plus and minus icon in a corner while in grid view. Very important is the histogram above. Three primary colors are shown: red, green and blue. If those overlap, the resulted secondary color is shown. And where all colors do overlap, the white color appears. Plus, the more a color is intense, the more it appears on the right of the histogram. For example, a picture with a deep red will show more red on the right. The height of a color peak is determined by the number of pixels that has such color. So a picture that is totally in red will have a high peak in red. If you need to edit photos into deep, switch to the Develop workspace. Select from the Quick Navigator the picture you need to adjust. On the left, you have some options. Presets has some ready-made filters that change the appearance of your photo. Hover one and check the final appearance through Navigator on top. Click on the filter to apply it on the photo. Use Ctrl and Z to undo. Snapshots saves a snapshot taken while your photo is being edited. Just click on the plus to create one. The snapshot saved looks like exactly what you see on the preview. Choose a snapshot to open it on your workspace anytime. History lists all your latest actions made, so that you can go backwards if you have mistaken. On top, you have the main navigator. This is used to check which part of the picture you are seeing, especially if you zoom in. On the right, below the color histogram scene, you have advanced tools to edit your photo into deep. Before doing so, save a snapshot of your original photo, so that you can come back to it whenever you need. First of all, you may need to cut from the picture all parts you don't like. You can do so by using the Crop Overlay tool. When you enable it, a grid appears on the photo. All that is included inside such will be saved. Simply drag the nodes on the corners to scale it. Hold Shift down to keep the aspect ratio while scaling. Drag from outside to rotate the grid. When you finish, simply click on Done below. Use Escape to undo. In case you need to flip the image, just go to Photo and then to Flip Horizontal or Vertical. Then, you may need to adjust lightness, contrast and colors. All these are inside Basic. First of all, choose to keep colors or make a black and white effect, selecting under Treatment. Use Temp and Tint to adjust colors. You can drag on the bar, use your mouse wheel, drag from the numbers, or click inside to type the precise value you need. Color neutrality is reached when all the three colors in the histogram are well overlapped. Then set exposure and contrast. Moreover, if you want to correct just the lightest parts of the photo, use highlights. To correct the darkest parts, use shadows. If you want to add or remove white, use whites and blacks. Always observe the histogram above. If you want to make the photo vivacious, use vibrance and saturation. If the photo is too blurry, increase clarity. If the basic section is not enough, you can use more powerful tools more at the bottom. Use tone curve to adjust whiter and darker parts of the photo carefully. In split toning, you can change the color, hue, and its intensity, saturation, for both highlights and shadows. Balance sets how these two have to interact. HSL is the same as split toning, with the difference that here you can act on each single color, setting the color, hue, the intensity, saturation, and also lightness, luminance. To correct blur and noise, use the tools inside detail section, observing the small close view above. You can add basic effects through the tools inside effects, adding vignette and grain. You can turn on and off each section effects clicking on the button in the top left corner. A section turned off disables any tool that modifies the picture. If you want to know more about photo effects, check out our video in this guide. There are also lens corrections and camera calibration. Check them. While you edit your picture, it is useful to compare it before and after your corrections. Make snapshots often and use the compare view to check them. Before is the original picture. After is the same picture after your corrections made, depending on the snapshot chosen. You can also choose different kinds of comparisons, clicking on the compare button. If the picture under after is okay, save it. Go to file and then to export. If you want to save it into your computer, keep hard drive above. In export location, click on choose to select the destination folder. In file naming, choose the name of your file, checking rename to and going to edit. In file settings, choose the file format, the quality and the color code. Then just go to export more below. In case you want to save a catalog, collect all the photos interested inside the quick collection. You can add photos to such catalog by hovering each photo and clicking on the circle in the top right corner. Then save the quick collection catalog, right clicking on it and going to save quick collection. Your personalized collection will appear under the collections section below. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide for more.